Good morning.
It's early today. Hola, amigos, and welcome back to Mexico, our ninth country. We have driven up from Los Cabos to La Ventana, which is a little town a few hours north, and we're up this morning for a very special reason. We just checked into an Airbnb for one night, and this is the view from our roof. We've just driven to the boat ramp here in this teeny tiny town, but we're about to jump in the water.
So we probably better actually explain what we're here for, since it didn't take very long for us to find them. As you can see, that's the shore. So Holly, why don't you tell us?
So they said it would take somewhere up to 30 minutes to find them, but we literally already saw one in the water and we pulled out maybe 100 feet from shore. So we are here searching for the Mobula Rays. So Mobula Rays are also known as devil rays. They're smaller family related to manta rays. And they have these large migrations that come through during this time of year between May and July. And they actually come all the way down to Cabo. So if you're in Cabo, you can do this. They're just late this season because it's currently mid-June. They're usually in Cabo by that time, but the water's too warm. So they're up here in La Ventana, which is about 2 hours north. So we've come up here because they're supposed to be traveling in what's called a super squadron. I don't really know what that means, but it's basically a massive group of up to hundreds or even thousands of these rays. So we get to swim with them. And oh my gosh, this is gonna be magical. The water is glass this morning.
See 20, there's thousands of them.
A super squadron!
Maybe it's just making it sting, but oh my god.
Jellyfish just wrapped around my legs.
Sounds like you're pretty unlucky, Holly. What kind of jellyfish?
I don't freaking know. The kind that hurts your skin. Don't get stung by a jellyfish the first time you jump off the boat.
So I started like moving and like trying to kick at it. I wasn't sure if something was biting me. And then it got wrapped around this leg and then on my arms. She said I was a blue bottle, a man o' war.
We pulled up the ladder and it was just full of pink tentacles.
Big, long ones. He was picking them off.
I didn't get any stingy or anything. I was right next to her.
It's just like it's on both arms and both legs. Like I can't even focus my attention on one spot.
Good thing you had something to.
Oh my god. If I didn't have the wetsuit on, the tentacles, we were pulling them off of here, it would have been all up my stomach and I don't think I could take much more.
All right, power through.
The rays were so crazy. Oh my goodness, it really exceeded my expectations. I really tried to not get my hopes up when I saw the photos of like hundreds of rays. I was just hoping to see like 20, but we just saw thousands. Like,
and the guide said that she hasn't seen this in forever. When she jumped in the water, she went, whoa!
So yeah,
we got really lucky.
They were so fast. It was like trying to run a marathon while breathing through a straw. It was so tiring. I was like, and then I tried to dive down and hold my breath and I just couldn't hold it for very long. So now we're heading back to Cabo and we're gonna stop in a little town called Todos Santos that we've heard quite a lot about for some lunch.
so hot. So we just came over to a restaurant. I think it's called El Mirador. It's the only restaurant, it looks like, in all of Todos Santos that actually has a view, because it's up on the hill and the rest of the town is kind of tucked behind. I don't know why it doesn't go all the way up to the beach, but this is incredible. Looks like a very nice restaurant. So we've just sat down for lunch. This is definitely a nicer place, and I feel very underdressed with crazy ocean hair and a swimsuit on still. But definitely looking forward to this chocolate brownie toffee caramel ice cream thing.
All right, we're headed back to Cabo now. Today was definitely memorable. I can't believe how many rays that we saw. I don't know if we caught it on camera, but our guide actually said that that's the most that she's seen in like years. We were expecting to see maybe 20, 30, like in a cluster school at a time, but we got the full migration of hundreds of them. So that was literally everything we could have dreamed of in like all the photos we saw. After the first time that I got stung, I was like, okay, just push through the pain. Like, it's not pain that's indicative of anything being wrong with you. It's just a sensory thing. So get back in the water. And it was as soon as I hit the water that literally it started stinging again. And I thought, oh, salt water. But I realized a few seconds later when I lifted my arm up and there was like a web.
It made no sense. It made no sense.
They had jumped in, what, 10 seconds earlier?
Well, I didn't see anything. Yeah, yeah. And so it was like this mysterious jellyfish attraction that Holly just had as soon as she would get in the water. What was cool is that Holly still got to like stick her face over the boat with the goggles on and like kind of snorkel from the boat. So she still got
the rest of the time
enjoy the migration and seeing it all from the boat without, you know, getting jellyfished.
But a third time.
Anyways, it was such a fun time we had here in Mexico. Don't forget to like, subscribe, all that stuff, and we'll see you next time.